A little boy lost, being put out on the street. Police evicting families from a public square in Port-au-Prince, consigning them to this. Many sought refuge here in July when gang warfare killed at least 300 people in 10 days. They've had little help from their failing state.
Well, what's happening here now is that people who have already been displaced once are being displaced again. Women have been leaving, clutching small children by the hand, carrying whatever they can manage. There's a real sense of despair now. They're wondering, where can they go to be safe?
Here's where they fled from, City Soleil, a place where most fear to tread. It's the poorest part of the capital and a bastion of the gangs. The UN's World Food Programme has to negotiate its way in to give out life-saving aid. It says 19,000 people here are facing famine-like conditions, a two-hour flight from Miami. All this is watched carefully by gang members who remain out of sight. They're also watching us as we film. We can't step outside the gate. How hard is it to try to feed your child? I can't feed my child, Sarah tells me. My little one is at my mother's. Every day we hear gunfire. And now there is another threat. Cholera has returned. Five-year-old Jocelyn has been hit hard. She's already weakened by malnutrition, like so many children here. With her godmother by her side, she gets help in time. But this is one more plague in a country that is running out of strength. The capital is menaced by gangs who own most of the streets. Haiti's government has asked for foreign troops to come in. So far, the international community is in no rush. There is anger at the idea of more foreign intervention. It has a bad history here. Many Haitians want their government out, not foreigners in. The state is collecting taxes, says Abner, but it can't collect the rubbish. It can't feed the people. We will fight until we overthrow it. Jean Simpson Desonclos has been fighting for a better Haiti as a lawyer and human rights activist. But no one is immune here. No one is safe. He lost his entire family, his wife, Josette Fils, and daughters, Sherwood Sonji and Sarah G. Here they were in life, sharing a happy moment. They were gunned down by a gang in August. Three women, no mercy. This was the family car just hours after the attack.
Yo prend yon pays en otage. Et yo fait la loi la dame. Yo tué. Yo violé. Yo détruit.
And they rob children of what little they have. Wood Berlin is 12. He and his mother are now homeless for the second time. First, they fled City Soleil. Now the authorities have moved them on. They told us they had no idea where they would go. Orla Guerin, BBC News, Port-au-Prince.